Welcome, welcome. It is me live, actually. Please do me a favor and share this. If you're in any groups, please share it, especially in Mississippi, especially in North Mississippi, and particularly in Oxford and Lafayette County. For 16 months, I've been on an independent investigation, getting to the bottom of everything that happened back in 2017. I just recently wrapped that investigation up. The results are shocking, to say the least. I want to take you back to July 7th of last year. That was the day that I had submitted my post-conviction relief to the circuit court in Lafayette County. The presiding judge that I would find out would be John Kelly Luther. For those that have followed my story, you'll see how conflict-ridden that has gotten. So I'm gonna go ahead and I'm gonna play this, okay? I have recently actually just finished the mastering on part one. This is a 15-minute segment. Feel free to leave your comments and your shares and likes are appreciated.
Part of my nightmare is over. All right. Hope everybody's doing all right today. Got it filed. Post-conviction relief has been filed in the Circuit Court of Lafayette County. I was reading off the motion on the way up here. The last day, the last hour, the last minute, but I got it in. I've hit every roadblock that there is seemingly known to man just in getting this bad boy filed. The circuit court clerk, Jeff Busby, actually spoke directly with the presiding judge, Judge Kelly Luther, to not give me a hearing, to not examine the evidence here of extreme corruption, government corruption, that took place at the hands of agencies tasked with protecting the American people. It chose in turn to turn a blind eye to obstruct justice, and even so bad as what all signs lead to believe as evidence tampering. What's up, WMC? You guys gonna cover a good story? Hey, who got to you guys as far as, like, not wanting to cover a legitimate public corruption scandal? A government corruption scandal. And y'all don't even want to even reach out to me and have a Zoom meeting. Because it doesn't fit the fake news narrative. I've been fucked nonstop by the liberal news media, trying to sweep the shit under the table. Don't know who got to them, but I do know that it's definitely not a part of the fear-mongering narrative. See, I want to know why WMCTV will not cover a legitimate breaking story. One that involves public corruption at its highest degree. Comes now the petitioner pro se and files this motion to set aside his plea of guilty and sentence rendered thereon, and in support would show to the court the following. One, that petitioner waived formal indictment in the 3rd District of the Circuit Court of Lafayette County, Mississippi for aggravated stalking, to wit, an AR-15 rifle with intent to place Todd and or Ashley Lynch in reasonable fear of great bodily injury. A copy of said criminal information was filed in this court on the 6th day of July, 2017, and attached hereto as Exhibit A. 2, that petitioner pled guilty to the aforementioned alleged crime and was sentenced by Circuit Court of Lafayette County, Mississippi on the 6th day of July, 2017, and cause number LK17-295 to 5 years in the custody of the Department of Corrections, with the balance of the sentence 5 years to be served on supervised probation, a true copy of which is attached hereto as Exhibit B. 3, that this motion is filed pursuant to Mississippi Code 99-39-5. 4, that the respondent was in direct violation of the petitioner's 1st, 8th, and 14th constitutional rights at the time the plea was given. 5, the petitioner's guilty plea was involuntary due to a denial of his due process rights as guaranteed by the United States and State of Mississippi constitutions, thus making his plea of guilty a violation of the laws of the State of Mississippi. 6, that petitioner received inadequate representation by his legal counsel. Furthermore, on record, in which adequate counsel representation likely would have resulted in an outright dismissal of the state's charge. Petitioner only met with his legal counsel one time, and no discovery motion was ever requested by the petitioner's legal counsel. That's Brennan Horan, by the way. Warren Lake, that the state has refused to comply with a Freedom of Information Act request for information regarding the phone call received on May 24, 2017, which through the state's own admission on a more recent public records request ultimately led to the charge being levied against petitioner. A copy of the state's admission to receiving a phone call and basing their allegation upon the information received is attached as Exhibit C. 8, if there exists additional evidence of material not reasonably discoverable at the time of involuntary plea and not previously presented and heard, which requires vacation of the conviction or sentence in the interest of justice. Wherefore, premises considered, plaintiff prays that the court will enter an order vacating and setting aside the guilty plea herein, book number LK17-295. That is my signature, and the document is now filed in an open legal matter in the circuit court right here behind me. I've got the public record as Exhibit C. This is where Lafayette County Sheriff's Department admits that they received a call, that Sheriff's Investigator Jared Bundren received a phone call on May 24th, 2017, which therein led to, well, it was a call stating that I was threatening Todd and Ashley Lynch and Frank and Marley's, which was not the case. In fact, I've got evidence of them being the ones threatening, of them creating a, well, I say them. I'm not going to go out and speak and say them as in the Lynch's, but a YouTube channel created like 15, 20 videos. Todd Lynch on video saying that there needs to be a problem resolution and that the members of the community, being Oxford, needed to come together and figure out a way to get rid of Matt Reardon. How do you dispute something like that? How can you dispute something like that? When he's on video saying, just days prior, to my false arrest, my illegal confinement, my First Amendment rights, my Eighth Amendment rights, my 14th Amendment rights, getting absolutely destroyed in a quid pro quo plot, which helped elect a female Democrat mayor, protect, shield the Lafayette County Sheriff's Department and Timmy Pruitt from the liability imposed by his unlawful arrest May 1st for me standing right here in front of that statue on public property holding the state flag back May 1st, 2017, which also helped get the problem out of the way for Frank and Marley's and the Lynches, and finally, which helped a mother of an almost two-year-old little girl at that time slide the father completely out of the way, but not his money out of the way. You see, they made sure to take out a withholding order for $600 a month in child support, knowing that I was innocent the entire time and playing a major part in this entire scandal, even being able to go down in the first place. And the most sickening thing of all is for Lafayette County Sheriff's Department to know without all reasonable doubt that I was innocent, to go through every extent they could to threaten me, to try to force my hand into submission, and through their own admission to have received the phone call which led to me getting arrested for something I didn't even do, I couldn't have possibly done, over three years ago, and to refuse to comply with a Freedom of Information Act request, a FOIA, a public records request, or information about the call received on May 24th, 2017. They want to keep the masked actor right there. I'm none. They want to keep him masked. The attorney for Lafayette County refused. He was gonna get a copy of that information to me the last minute. And at the last minute, he decided to seal up the record as confidential, something that fell out of the scope of the Freedom of Information Act. A Marine Corps veteran who wrote a blank check to our government for an amount up to and including his life back at the end of 2007. A patriotic American, a conservative, and a 3%er that would never cause anybody any kind of harm, but only be there to protect himself and his family and those around unable to defend themselves.
In the Circuit Court of Lafayette County, Mississippi, Matthew Oliver Reardon versus State of Mississippi, cause number L20-316. This is a motion for relief from judgment or order. Comes now before the court, Matthew Reardon, the petitioner and plaintiff, and respectfully moves this court for relief from judgment. Cause number L20-316. Petitioner would show just cause through the upcoming reasons listed. Showing to the court the following reasons Movan is entitled to relief. Fraud committed on behalf of Lafayette County officials and employees. A. MRCP Rule 5.1B3 states if a person is taken into custody, the person shall be taken without unnecessary delay, and in no event later than 48 hours after arrest, before a judge who shall proceed with an initial appearance. The aforementioned cited rule goes on to state, if the person arrested is not taken before a judge within 48 hours, the person detained shall be released on execution of an appearance bond in the minimum amount set pursuant to Rule 8 and directed to appear at a specified time and place. Rule 5.1B3 forms the United States Supreme Court holdings in Gerstein v. Pugh. 2. That petitioner, Movan, was deprived of due process rights guaranteed to him by both state and federal law. Petitioner was unlawfully confined at the Lafayette County Detention Center for 6 weeks' time. Petitioner was denied the opportunity to obtain a lower bond amount that fell within reasonable guidelines which petitioner or his family could afford. Moviat was held on a bond set 3 times higher than guidelines allow, despite the state of Mississippi not producing so much as a piece of evidence suggesting it had a valid claim. Petitioner in this cause asserted he had evidence to prove he couldn't have committed such a crime alleged, petitioner never being accused of a felonious crime prior, and absolutely no injuries inflicted upon the claimant. A habeas corpus petition was filed by the public defender demanding the sheriff of Lafayette County to bring petitioner before the court to show just cause for the illegal confinement of the petition. And while the petition approved to proceed via informa pauperis, petitioner was never brought before the court and was further illegally confined for an additional 4 weeks' time. Petitioner was never made aware of this habeas petition ever being filed until nearly 6 months later, when he found out on his own. This amounts to misrepresentation by petitioner's counsel, and petitioner's been requesting answers to no avail, making the petitioner question whether fraud had occurred, yet unsure whether the true liability and responsibility falls. Due process rights entitle the defendant in a cause to receive a preliminary hearing to determine if there's enough evidence warning the defendant to stand trial. Petitioner was never afforded a preliminary trial within 14 days as required by law, which in the absence of a preliminary hearing within 14 days requires that the defendant be released on his own personal recognizance and be given a court date and time. This never happened. All requests by petitioner to have his bond lowered to a constitutionally fit amount went completely ignored after being given a bond amount that was 3 times higher than the maximum guidelines established less than a year prior by the Mississippi Supreme Court. That established guidelines established called for an alleged crime punishable by a maximum up to 10 years incarceration to be set in the range of $5,000 to $50,000. Petitioner's alleged crime, yada yada yada. The crime Movant was accused of included a maximum fine of $3,000 and a maximum incarceration of 5 years. The bond set in this case was nowhere in the vicinity of established guidelines set by the Mississippi Supreme Court. Movant petitioner never caused any physical harm to anyone, had never been accused of a felony crime prior to this allegation. Bond is not supposed to be set in a punitive way, only to ensure the defendant shows up to appearances. Movant slash petitioner had pending ongoing litigation against Lafayette County due to a highly contestable arrest made on May 1st, 2017, when Movant was arrested for disorderly conduct simply for standing on public property holding the then state flag of Mississippi. Movant states that it is this reason, along with his child and girlfriend at the time, which would have easily shown and conveyed the fact that Movant was not a flight risk, not to mention Movant is a Marine Corps veteran that had never had any prior history of being a flight risk. Therefore, it is entirely the impression of the Movant that bond was used in a punitive way by a Justice Court Judge Carolyn Bell that has had a history of setting bonds in the lower end of bond guidelines. Movant petitioner was held, restricted, suppressed, and illegally confined in the Lafayette County Detention Center from the time of his arrest on May 26, 2017 until he received an initial bond hearing on May 30th. This amounted to nearly 96 hours before Movant was brought before a judge. This was twice the maximum length allowable under Mississippi Rules of Criminal Procedure, which was readopted less than a year prior. Movant was not only denied a reasonable bond for Lafayette County's egregious errors, but Justice Court Judge Carolyn Bell's bond issued appearance bond of $150,000 for a presumably innocent American by longstanding court precedents showed bond being used in a punitive way to influence the outcome of a sham legal proceeding, which was initiated by Lafayette County in the state of Mississippi, its employees, along with elected and appointed officials under knowingly false pretenses. The fact that Movant was interrupted by Judge Bell and advised of his Fifth Amendment rights on 2 separate occasions when he tried to show information up front which would show the impossibility of Mobe to have committed the alleged crime, should concern and frighten every American. Petitioner asserts, in complete confidence, what all concluding evidence would demonstrate as a clearly shown political attack on petitioner by way of criminal conspiracy, racketeering, organized crime, and the successful deprivation and continued deprivation of the petitioner's rights.
I'm gonna talk real quickly, and then I'm gonna put it on this video. Show some interesting things. This phone conversation that I have with Kathy Sturdivant. She's the court administrator for Judge John Kelly Luther, Circuit Court Judge, Senior Circuit Court Judge. There's an absolute catastrophe going on right now with the Mississippi judiciary. Okay? It is an absolute shit show. Okay? My due process rights of the accused were never afforded to me back in 2017. It's the only reason why I was compelled to plea out to a crime that, quite frankly, was never committed. There was never a crime. That was the first and only time that I will ever sell my soul to the devil. That's what I kind of look at it as when I plead out. I will never plea out to anything ever again. Period. It has been hell on earth, to put it very lightly. Okay? My life has literally just been turned inside out. I've started doing the documentary Riding with the Outlaw in order to document the extreme uphill battle in seeking vindication and justice against the truly guilty parties. Plotted against me back in 2017 that saw benefit from their plotting. And a warrior never gives up. I'm not giving up this fight. The Mississippi Court of Appeals, I turned in my appellate brief on Friday. It's kind of a bit weird, because Len Fitch, the Attorney General, is listed on there as far as representing Mississippi. Vicki Mallett, District Attorney. There's another one, Samantha something, and then another attorney just entered as lead counsel for the state of Mississippi. Four attorneys against me. It's going to be fun, interesting. Here's the thing. Just over the last 16 months, getting to the bottom of the facts, all the details, gathering all the evidence, I have been retaliated upon by the Lafayette County Sheriff's Department. Ones that were guilty, and particularly Sheriff Joey East. 9 charges put against me in Justice Court. All Lafayette County Justice Court judges have recused themselves due to conflict of interest. So they brought in a judge from another county. It happened to be Union County. A judge by the name of Judge Garrison. Now, thought Judge Garrison was going to be all right. Judge Garrison, come to find out, actually recused himself last week. So another judge is recused. Very weird. Actually looked at the order. Judge Garrison actually... It just... Something's not adding up right there with that order. He put in there that I had... That he was recusing himself because of conflict of interest, because I had threatened Tannehill Law Firm. And his daughter works at Tannehill Law Firm. Now, it's very odd because the judge should know the name of law firms. A judge whose daughter works at a particular law firm should certainly know the name of the law firm. It's certainly not Tannehill Law Firm. It's Tannehill, Carmine, and McKenzie. Now, I never, not one time, did I ever threaten the Tannehill, Carmine, and McKenzie Law Firm, or as Judge Garrison put it, the Tannehill Law Firm. Not once. So I'm actually publicly compelling Judge Garrison to release where he got that hearsay, because he never put allegedly in his order that he signed recusing himself. And what that ultimately did is that tainted my case for the next judge. Now, another odd thing about that is in that order, he had made mention. In that order, he had made mention that he was appointed to that, to my 9 Justice Court charges by Judge John Kelly Luther, who should have recused himself on my post-conviction relief matter. He is the presiding judge from 2017. He was made aware of all crimes committed by Lafayette County officials and employees in advance. Insisted on staying in, even though there's another judge assigned to the case, Judge Kent Smith. Now, Judge John Kelly Luther has had an obligation to recuse himself many times, has refused to do that. And I got to say, I hope it bites him in the ass when it's all said and done. But for this judge, this circuit court judge, for 1 second to think it's okay to pick who the judge is on the Justice Court matters, the completely sham 9 charges, ridiculously sham. The only thing that I truly was guilty for in that was an expired tag. Okay, that was the only thing out of everything given that I take accountability for at the time. I had an expired tag. Everything else completely sham. Completely sham. Lies. And it's become clear to me that the whole plan with the Justice Court fiasco is to throw as many different charges at the wall like they're spaghetti noodles to see what sticks. Even if nothing sticks, at least we can paint this guy to look like a criminal or look as bad as possible for whatever judge is ruling over his case. All along, Judge John Kelly Luther clearly is deciding who's going to rule over my case. Now, isn't this a bit of a coincidence? Because a judge that quite possibly could be criminally involved, for all I know, because he was made aware of all the crimes committed, he took it on himself to step into another judge's role that was assigned to my post-conviction relief and override that judge and deny my motions. I'm going to play this video, this call that I had with Kathy. This is an absolute moral outrage.
Miss Kathy.
Yes.
You've always been a very sweet lady to me and always a very straight shooter, it seems like.
Aw, well, thank you so much. What lovely time was on a Friday. Thank you.
Is it Friday, really? Yeah, it is Friday. Oh, my gosh. Miss Kathy, you've got a grievance. This is Matt Reardon.
Yes, sir.
I had just been made aware that the Justice Court judge from Union County that was assigned Union County Judge Garrison had recused himself, and I just got sent the order and I read over it. And I think
that's my understanding too, Matt. However, a new order has just been issued. And you're supposed to be copied on it at a later time. It hasn't had a chance to work through the system with the mail and what have you. But there already has been a new judge assigned to that.
I'm going to have to probably challenge that. I was not aware. See, here's my problem. Is that in regards to all the circuit court stuff, that's just a mess. The Supreme Court, you know, the name, the judge's name, I feel like 100%
After I put in the motion for recusal on Judge Luther, I feel like in the circuit clerk's office, the judge's name was fraudulently altered from Kent Smith, which is who it was assigned to Judge John Kelly Luther. I actually have screenshots through August where it actually reflected Judge Kent Smith as the presiding judge over my circuit court matter. But yet, Judge Luther kept overriding that and ruling denying the motions and refused to recuse himself. I thought that, you know, being that he was made aware prior to the post-conviction relief matter, he was made aware of crimes committed by Lafayette County officials through the detailed email that I'd sent to you.
I'm going to have to stop you there. I know your grievances have been many. Anytime judges recuse at the justice court level, it's procedurally appropriate that the circuit judge reappoint someone else.
No, but I'm saying Judge John Kelly Luther is not the proper judge to be appointing judges over another matter. I think he has an obligation to step aside. Right, but in light of the claims, the conflicts of interest that have been raised in regards to, you know, being made aware of the stuff up front on the post-conviction relief, I think that he has an obligation to pass it to another judge to assign the judges for justice court.
You know, the only way, and this is part of your problem, Matt, is you represented yourself pro se in all the matters that I'm aware of, as opposed to having, you know, professional legal counsel. All I can tell you is everyone, including yourself, that has any issues before justice court or city court or circuit court has to know how to file the appropriate motions and have them presented to the court. And I think that part of your problem is that procedurally you don't know how to do all those things. Now, I understand that you say you cannot afford legal counsel, but I would encourage you at this point to obtain some legal counsel so that you can go forward, you know, with sound legal advice.
It sounds like I'm having to watch and duck my head from Judge John Kelly Luther. I mean, I don't think I've done anything wrong procedurally when it comes to filing a motion.
Well, I assure you, Mr. Reardon, that Judge Luther has not done anything inappropriate. And, you know, you're welcome to write him a letter if you like. But
when's he going to be in Lafayette County?
He is the senior circuit judge. And
is he there today?
He has done everything by the rules. You know, he's, of course, not only a juris doctor, he's the senior circuit judge. So nothing he has done has been wrong or inappropriate.
Well, I'd like to ask him some questions. Is he in Oxford today?
No, he's not. And also, Matthew, and this is another problem for you, I realize, and I, as much as I would love to assist you, I'm not in a position to do so. But another problem is, while you have ongoing pending matters before the court, it would be inappropriate for the judge to speak with you directly. That's against the rules.
Just like if I have pending matters in the circuit court and Supreme Court, it would be inappropriate for that same judge that I have issues with in another court to be assigning judges in justice court.
Without the other side being present.
But it's no different than jury selection. It's no different than juror selection when there's a conflict of interest that's picking the judge.
I'm going to need an answer from the Judge Garrison Camp I'm going to need an answer from the Tannehill, Carmine, and McKenzie camp. The way I see it is this. Ray Tannehill, Jay Carmine, Matt McKenzie. They're a powerhouse. I couldn't be posing a threat unless they were referring to being a physical threat.
rumors are steadily getting spread. Clearly, I'm going to need to see supporting evidence, because millions of splinters were sent through this area and surrounding areas. Lies and bullshit in 2017, and this is complete proof. Complete proof. I'd also like a more defined answer than what I got. Judge John Kelly Luther's office, as to how they do not think that this is a conflict of interest, and how they do not think that any adverse ruling in justice court, which I've claimed, and I've even offered evidence to show that they are sham charges. I believe they're there just to stack the deck against me to make me look bad. So, I would like to know how in the hell the way conflict of interest works, the clear tie that's going on here, clear tie to him, as far as Judge John Kelly Luther being the presiding judge in a case that's currently in the Supreme Court, Court of Appeals, how Judge John Kelly Luther doesn't feel that this would not call for, would not be manifest error that would require a reversal on appeal. Should there be any findings of guilt at trial? Now, I would love to know why these sham charges levied against me love to know why they're so important to Lafayette County to recuse all of their judges, to get another judge, Union County, that recuses himself, and despite valid reasons listed and supportive evidence of why these charges, and in particular ones that I named, but all of them, are so worth it to the county, to its officials, to the taxpayers and their money, to Lafayette County, is it not enough to destroy, to know that I was innocent the entire time? But you knew it since the beginning, because it was all part of a stage plan anyways. But to know that you destroyed a man's life and his opportunities, and it's because of that that you brought him right back with a camera, microphones, on an investigative journalism / reporting mission. The courts won't do the right thing in curtailing and truly dealing a crushing blow to the corrupt actors, the ones that have abused their positions of power, then I hope, riding with the outlaw will, because that's really been my goal since the beginning. It's a method to help hold those, especially in power, accountable and responsible. I wanted to send a strong, lasting message that regardless or not, whether or not you get caught and held accountable by the courts, you might not want to try to frame an innocent person, abuse the legal system, and destroying that person's life. Because you never know when that person may get the bright idea to go ahead and start working on a documentary and produce a documentary that's directly about you. Okay? that then becomes an item that's protected by the First Amendment.
Yes, sir. I called over a week ago now, probably a week and a half ago, in regards to the craziest of matters back in 2017. It was a scandal that deprived me of my rights, my due process rights, all of them. And I'm just fighting for my life here. I'm in desperate need of congressional authority, of the help of Congress, the Senate, and I was told that you know, I believe I may have spoken to you, that it's an issue that Senator Smith would be interested in hearing about, and I never did hear anything back.
Yes, sir. I passed it along to the senator and said that she's not going to be able to do much, and that Governor Reeves would probably be your best bet for any help for that matter.
Okay, well, I mean, surely anybody's better than just me on my own. I mean, the matter actually just got a lot more serious. The circuit court judge that has literally, he's been in the way on everything, refused me an evidentiary hearing, was he was of knowledge of crimes committed by Lafayette County officials, and still has chosen to not recuse himself. I've got 9 charges against me in justice court. All the judges in Lafayette County have recused themselves. Now the Union County judge has recused himself, which is strikingly odd right there, that all these judges are recusing. And come to find out, the judge that is actually picking the judges to rule over my justice court cases is the same circuit court judge that, you know, I feel like is criminally liable. And what a coincidence that, you know, absconding with the liability by picking a favorable judge to get rid of his problem.
Yes, sir. I've already passed this message along, and I don't think there's going to be anything that this office should be able to help you with.
I don't. I see Matt Gaetz down in Florida. You know, that's you know, certainly taking an interest in due process rights. You know, being deprived of citizens, and I don't know why. You know, my own state senator, who's a Republican, is refusing to even assist. I feel like this is every single person's turned their back on me just to let me just drown out here. I'm fighting all these battles by myself, and I can't even get my own senator. Like, what's going on? It's America.
I'm sorry, sir. That's all I'm doing. I'm just time. I wish I had a better answer for you.
Well, I know that she certainly lost a constituent with that decision, and if I have anything to say about it, it would be a lot more than just me for not showing any kind of interest in going to help.
Yes, sir. Well, I'm
convey that to her.
Oh, well. All right.
Okay.
Have a good day.
pleased. How you doing, sir? I needed to get a little Q&A with you. You don't do Q&A's?
No.
Oh, can you answer a few questions for me?
No, I can't.
Why is the county not wanting to comply on the public records request? You told me...
You don't have to ask the county.
Let me see your service. Where's your service record at, Blowhard Buff? So why can't you apply the law equal?
I do. You're a convicted felon.
Per the rights granted to me in the Constitution, I have every right to obtain justice, to seek justice.
We will comply. You said submit it and we'll comply. Why haven't I gotten... Why haven't I gotten the... Sheriff, is this really the position you're going to take? Y'all will not respond to anything. Any email, any public records request, anything. I want to know why. I am holding our county officials accountable.
To seek justice. Every right. Granted to me under the United States Constitution. Under the United States Constitution. You're a fucking son of a bitch.
Yes, sir.
Clay Joyner, can I help you?
Clay Joyner. Matt Reardon.
Well, good time for you know.
Yes, yes. You're the acting U.S. attorney? Okay. All right. So a couple of grievances that I have. First of all, Bob, I wanted to find out. I wanted to see if you actually took, you know, if you said this was true or if you refuted it. Liz Crowder, she had long claimed, back to when we first got together, that her adoptive grandparents, her dad's adoptive parents, were a woman. In Olive Branch, the judge lets her off.
Your Honor, how did I do
that?
I was simply trying to inquire on the outcome of my ass. She falsely accused me of rape. You created a monster.
Please, take him all back. Take him all back. Hold it back, sir. I'm going to hold you in the court. Take him all back.
Your Honor, I was just take trying to address back. This.
All right, sir. Let's go. Come on. You want
to go? Go? I am holding Your Honor charged with contempt for simply doing exactly what I was told to do.
The Earlene Gardner Victim Assistance Project. What do you guys know about that? Actually found out they keep coming in representing Liz as her defense attorney. They represented her when Olive Branch charged her with filing a false report of rape. I was the victim. I was completely victimized in all of this. They represented her. Their funding does not come from the state, does not come local. It comes from the Department of Justice.
And one other quick question I had for you. What about... If you remember, you know, thinking back right before my arrest, I think it might have been the 24th or it was probably the 24th or the 23rd of May. I know it's a good while back, but you had reached out to me several times. And, you know, there were several statements made. I know Todd Lynch, if you look at the homepage of MattReardon.com, just crazy evidence. And then the restraining order filing by Ray Tannehill, it said that numerous complaints were called into Oxford Police Department, you know, that I was a dangerous person. And of course, you were the police chief and you had reached out to me a few times, you know, in the days prior to my arrest. What was that about? Did you receive some kind of complaint or something?
Man, I'd have to go back and look. I remember, yeah, people were concerned about you walking around with a loaded AR-15 was the biggest thing I can.
But that was the day before. That was the day before my arrest. That was May 25th. That was the day before my arrest. I didn't walk around with it prior to that.
From several incidents, I can't recall
offhand. I mean, I don't think my behavior was any more erratic than what Todd Lynch's was.
I don't know that I had any calls with Todd Lynch.
Well, I mean. You got to look at, okay,
look at it, it was two different sides of the political spectrum. I mean, conservatives aren't really known for calling in complaints on liberals, like liberals being known for calling in complaints on conservatives. I mean, that's just a political divide right there.
Call me back or come by and see me. I got somebody sitting in my office right now.
All right, Jay.
She says it's her community involvement that helped her prepare for the role she's in now.
You know, that doesn't really prove anything, but other than us as a community, we do need to get together and try to figure out our problem resolution here, because Matt Reardon is a danger to our society, and he's going to be a problem. Mark my words.
Who are you trying to protect? Is it that there's no call that came in, or is it that there's somebody like Robin Tannehill or Ray Tannehill that's on that call? I want to know. Why are y'all cowards? Why are y'all cowards? I'm saying I would like to, I'm trying to ask
you. Said no to an interview.
You said no to?
Now that's why it's not true.
You do realize you're a public servant, right? Jared Bundren. Hey, I'm here to show you how to conduct a proper investigation. I would like to, do you have a minute?
No, I don't.
You don't? You received a call on May 24th, 2017. I would like the details of that call. Jared, I put in a public records request. I put in a public records request. Why are y'all not complying with the public records request? It's ridiculous, guys.
I wanted to update you on the latest regarding the production of Riding with the Outlaw. I just released a couple of really big things on MattReardon.com. The facts of everything by now should alarm and frighten every citizen who values their own civil rights. Sadly, from what in my opinion can mainly be contributed to a complete moral decay in the fabric of society, the outrage over everything that has occurred and continues to occur is minimalized and muted. The tension has started climbing again in Lafayette County Justice Court as conflicts arise with trial nearing at the same time I wind down my 16-month independent investigation, which has yielded some very scary, bizarre, shocking, and alarming facts, evidence, and discovery. I have a stern message for Lafayette County Sheriff's Department, and in particular, Sheriff Joey East. I have now released what by all means should be considered exculpatory evidence showing more lies, exaggeration, and complete abuse of the legal system by Liz Crowder. I did my due diligence in reporting the crimes committed against me over and over again. For this, I was further attacked with more absurd charges levied against me, which make up at a very bare minimum 6 of the current 9 charges, and in my opinion and observation, all 9. Yet an unscathed Crowder continues to orchestrate, manipulate, lead this all-out witch hunt persecution. After going on hiatus for nearly 13 months in 2020, cutting off all communication, visitation, and even eyesight between a father and his daughter, based on ridiculous conspired upon lies and false affidavits filed in Chancery Court to buy time and stretch that time out as long as possible. No punishment for that, though. Meanwhile, deeper attacks on the one that has continued to aggrieve more and more damages at the hands of a broken system that downright refuses to take accountability and responsibility for its wrongs and mistakes. Even more concerning is the complete hack representing her as an advocate. The Erlane Gardner Victim Assistance Project, this completely shameful, sham organization, has continued operating in unscrupulous ways that truly toss ethics and moral decency far from this picture. My first taste came last year when they mysteriously chose to represent Liz Crowder and Olive Branch after she chose to plot and conspire to falsely accuse me of rape in November of 2018. After seeing all the planned out text messages and hearing a recorded phone call in which Liz admitted that she had initiated the false complaint in large part due to her current husband, Then more recently, she's heard on reporting saying the false accusation of rape was a failed plan of Ray Tannehill's. So which one is it, Liz? Can anyone seem to hold her accountable? And does anybody even care that under penalty of perjury is a loosely used term that is only selectively applied? Or is there too much of a want to crowd up the court dockets in various courts in a continuous attempt to overwhelm the one that was truly victimized and truly lost everything at the hand of despicable lies and at the expense of the taxpayers? Regardless of how many lies and false claims are committed and initiated, for Lafayette County and the county prosecutor, it's a game of connect the dots on a knowingly false narrative pushed by Lafayette County that has bizarrely continued to spin off course more and more as time dragged on, involving more and more individuals in its sick and sinister devised plan to abscond with its true guilt and liability. Isn't it a bit of a coincidence that the FBI was unable to locate the report from the interview on 5/25/2017? The U.S. Attorney, Bob Norman, whom advised that I speak with them, now won't answer a single question, particularly in regards to the alleged family tie to Liz Crowder that I more recently discovered. Then, to make matters worse, this DOJ agency calls Oxford Police Department on July 19, 2021 to have them order me off the property, in turn savagely violating the First Amendment rights of a private citizen and reporter whom simply sought out answers to his grievances in a peaceful, non-disturbing way, only to find out even more recently that the source of funding for this sham organization, the Earlene Gardner Victim Assistance Project, flows directly from the Department of Justice. Not private funds, not state funds, but federal funds tied directly back to the Department of Justice themselves. An agency doing a wonderful job showing that they are the financiers of crime, continuing to happen, and clearly don't care to hide the fact what gives off all feelings and impressions of mob rule. See more at MattReardon.com.
Joey. Joey knows I'm out here waiting. He needs to come out and talk to me. I'll move when I talk to Joey. When Joey wants to talk to me, I'll move. Otherwise, I'm not breaking any law just for parking in a spot that says reserved for the Sheriff's Department.
One more time.
I'm here at the Sheriff's Department.
Move. Or you will go to jail for disorderly.
I'm not being disordered. I'm moving my car! I'm moving my car! I was moving my car! Well, I'm still trying to get to the bottom of everything. It's been fraudulent concealment out the ass. You know you guys are holding on to something, they're not giving up.
You know what? I'm not, there's no point in me responding to that, because you're not going to...
You're not going to read them anyway.
I just want to know.
Right.
The C is for the courage I possess through the trial. They kicked me out because I couldn't hack it. I'd like to see it. It's a general under other than honorable conditions for alcohol rehabilitation failure because because I witnessed two gruesome suicides because I couldn't hack it. Let me see your service. Where's your service record at, blowhard buff?
For 10 years in the Marine Corps. They're not an honorable discharge.
Oh, yeah? So why can't you apply the law equal?
I do. You're a convicted felon.
Okay, and I've also heard the right to be in the Constitution. I have every right to obtain justice. To seek justice. Every right. Granted to me under the United States Constitution. Under the United States Constitution. You're a crooked son of a bitch.